live from Austin, Texas. It's theCUBE, covering OpenStack Summit 2016. Brought to you by the OpenStack Foundation and headline sponsors Red Hat and Cisco. Now here are your hosts, Stu Miniman and Brian Gracely.
Welcome back to theCUBE. SiliconANGLE Media's flagship program. Go out to all the shows, extract the signal from the noise. Love talking to a broad spectrum of ecosystem players here in the community. I'm Stu Miniman, joined by Wikibon's lead cloud and DevOps analyst, Brian Gracely. It's day one of three of our coverage. Happy to have on two first-time guests of theCUBE. We've got Dave Lincoln, who's the general manager of Lenovo's Data Center Group, and Stuart McRae, Director of Product Marketing, also with Lenovo's Data Center Group. Gentlemen, thanks so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having us. Right.
So Dave, we'll start with you. You know, most people know Lenovo from just broad spectrum of solutions. Of course, there's PC business, a lot of consumer business. Took the x86, business over from IBM. But can you just give us a little bit? You know, what's your role there? What's that encompass? And how do we think about Lenovo in kind of the data center enterprise side?
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, so we, I would say back in 2012, Lenovo at the highest levels made a determination that we were going to go and start to hedge out from PCs. We've, done a good job ever since the PC acquisition of the IBM system in 2005, eventually kind of claiming number one and, kind of starting to break away from the rest of the pack. But the PC business, the margins aren't as, say, healthy as they are in the data center area. So. And back in 2012, we made a decision to start to go deep into that, and since then, we've had a lot of success. We started down the organic path, and while we were going down the organic path, we were approached by IBM about the System X business, which was a perfect fit. We had a lot of success integrating the PC business a few years before that. So. The last six quarters, we've been busy stabilizing and completing that integration. And really, if you look at the combined business for the first time since 2010, the business has kind of bottomed in the quarter that ended September and the quarter that ended December. We actually grew 8 points year to year, which is the first time, like I said, since 2010. But and I can't talk about the quarter that just ended, but the point being is that no sooner than we were starting to bottom and get the ship turned around, the leadership realized that to be a proper data center provider, we needed to expand into the adjacent categories of data center infrastructure. So in September, we launched the hyperscale business unit. In October, our business unit, the storage business unit, was born. And then the convergent networking business units were born in November. So a lot of investment, a lot of focus behind this. And so that's it in a nutshell, what we got going on.
Yeah. So a lot of pieces, we'll have time to dig into many of them, but Stuart, let's pull you in. Tell us, why is Lenovo here at OpenStack? What are you guys doing at OpenStack? I mean, a lot of software pieces, and of course that has to live somewhere, but
sure,
how does Lenovo fit in the picture?
It's a very dynamic time in the industry for us, and we see a lot of convergence in the industry, a convergence in the traditional storage today. For us, the big future is software-defined storage. We're here because OpenStack is, we believe, a big part of that. As the consolidation in the industry happens, combined at the same time with a desire to move storage stacks from a traditional model to an open model and a software-defined model, that's where we're focused. Plays very well to our strengths, and we're looking at driving innovation with a range of software-defined storage providers, OpenStack being the foundation for many of those.
All right. So, let's talk a little bit about storage. So,
okay.
What can you talk about, how Lenovo looks at storage, where they fit into it, and, kind of what you have, what you OEM, what you partner?
Yeah, so, as we were trying to kind of formalize what our strategy was going to be, this is back in the fall, that we're now starting to execute on, it was quickly apparent that there's never been so much flux in the industry, both in terms of the competitive dynamics, big acquisitions, you maybe have heard about, and then even just the technological flux. So, we've been doing a lot of customer briefings, and they kind of come in, and quickly it rises to the surface that because of all this change, because of all this uncertainty, it's given us a windows of opportunity to compete, and customers are looking for a choice. They're looking to hear what we have to say. So,
yeah, and what's driving? I mean, we understand from an industry perspective, like you said, you've got some major acquisitions and things going on in the market. You've got some other vendors who are struggling to kind of deal with transitions in the business. What are you hearing from customers that are saying, hey, look, we're now open to software-defined storage. We're now open to converge. What's driving their business to come have those conversations with you?
Yeah, I think it's a few things. One's the consolidation. So there's a mass of customers out there who have to make a new investment in storage. They see on the horizon that maybe what they're buying today is not going to be there tomorrow. At the same time, there's a desire to kind of separate what I call the data plane and the control and management plane. So as they move more of the orchestration to an OpenStack kind of environment or a more traditional control plane, it changes the way they think about the base storage, right? So the attributes they really wanted, they've always wanted, great performance, rock solid availability, service and support, they still want that, but they're not willing to pay for the features, right? The feature innovation has slowed down to some extent, and it's moving to a different area in the control plane. That's an area in a traditional space where we'll really focus hard and driving efficiencies in that. At the same time, if they're looking for a different scale, right? So a traditional storage, when they look to software defined, when they're moving from their traditional world to a much larger scale, it's not really manageable in a traditional scale-up storage stack, right? They want to go broad in that, and software defined is a perfect design point for that. Also, as they look to object storage, right? That's one of the things that we see as more and more customers. It's a little bit Wild West now, but they want to really move as much of their data to that as possible. And solutions, either OpenStack or S3 kind of environments, are really where they want to move to do that.
Yeah, let me just add to that. And so that's a little bit about the kind of the product dynamics, the shifts going on. But even just from a general business model, I think it's ripe for disruption. We've had a number of folks come into our briefing centers, and a lot of folks with EMC and their environments. And I think the business model is kind of a bit tiring. We've talked to them, and the game is that if they don't re-up with the latest VNX generation, they get hammered on their maintenance costs and that sort of thing. So I think even one customer we had talked about that they have some small version of Stockholm syndrome. So I think literally they did. That was their words. So I thought it was awesome. But I think the whole thing is ripe to be disrupted, not just from a product perspective, but also just the business model.
Yeah. I mean, Dave, one of the things we've commented for years. I mean, storage is not homogeneous. It's a very fragmented marketplace. Seems to be coming even more so. So even if you just talk kind of what type of customers you've got, the SMB, you've got enterprise, you've got service providers, and you got the hyperscale guys.
Right.
What pieces of those does Lenovo look at? How do you rationalize? Is it different strategies across the board?
Yeah, I don't know that we have a hyperscale business unit that's targeting the big seven here locally, and then you add the big three in China. We have unbelievable business going in China. I want to say that I think we had like 40% market share for the quarter that just ended, something like that, in China. So we're trying to leverage a lot of those best practices that we got going in China, bringing that here outside of China. But for the kind of general purpose sales, I think any customer that cares about TCO, choice, customer service, simplicity, we're targeting them. I don't know that we're...
I don't know anybody particularly.
So, what do you think?
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, we talk about at the event here, you meet with some users, mostly partner discussions, and maybe if you can give us a little insight as to how users talk about OpenStack, Stuart.
Yeah, I think they talk about OpenStack as a way to free up and deliver more innovation than what they have today. So we view it as very compatible with industry standard hardware and industry standard software. As they're looking to innovate and provide new functionality, the innovation ability in an OpenStack environment is much quicker than going to a traditional provider for compute application software or storage software. And we look at it as, it simplifies their model from a development model as a customer, and to provide solutions, a simpler development model, because they've got the base already there. For us, when we partner with the providers, it allows us to provide a great story with them, because we can innovate in the latest, greatest. Compared to a traditional model, where if you want to add functionality, performance, whether it be the next generation flash or processor, that's really like a two-year development cycle for traditional customers, traditional providers. For us, that's almost instantaneous. When you get on the open world, where we can deliver the next generation of performance at a very affordable price with a software innovation, it really frees them up to take advantage and deliver a business value immediately as opposed to waiting 24 months.
Yeah, you talked a little bit about China. Lenovo is obviously an international company. Sometimes we get a little bit siloed here. We think about the U.S. companies, sort of the U.S. market. What do you see outside of the U.S., not just in China, but that might surprise some people, or that you guys feel like also gives you an advantage because you've got broader reach, broader visibility into sort of the challenges of the world?
Yeah, it's absolutely a different market. It's a little bit off topic, but just the 4U market and high end market's very different than say what we see outside. So the buying preferences for that market's very different, and but not surprisingly, I would say that the going down market, kind of bang for buck, price performance is absolutely, I think, the number one in that space.
So Stuart, any commentary on just kind of open source globally as to, how, as Brian said, from kind of cloud, we tend to look very North American centric first, and then kind of the globe catches up. Anything you can comment on kind of some of the global impacts of, cloud
and open
source?
I think we're probably sitting here a little bit myopic on the North America market. Yeah. I would say in Asia and China specifically, there's a tremendous focus on that. The hyperscale, companies there are very large, and while we may not hear of them that often in the U.S., they have tremendous scale, and they have the same problems that any large hyperscale company has here. So, the innovation and development is very aggressive, and I think from a general application perspective and being able to develop more homegrown solutions, OpenStack and the open environment is critical to those, because they've already got the foundation, right? So it allows them to develop a solution for their unique customer environments.
Yeah, well, the software-defined storage market is interesting because, as much as you're talking about, like you said, control plane and data plane and gigabytes and so forth, you're also talking about APIs and you're talking about DevOps and deploying things faster. Are you seeing the customer makeup, who's in the room when you're having discussions, change? Are you starting to see developers be there? Is it still driven by ops teams just trying to deliver capacity faster? How does the dynamic change when it's software-defined storage versus, kind of the old, two-head box mentality?
Yeah, that's a good question. I think, as we often say in technology, it depends. And it depends on the flavor. When we look at a true, straight-up storage solution, it's kind of still the same people. The people who own the storage infrastructure, and they're looking for, a lot of times not to replace what they have, but to add to it and augment it. And I think their strategy over time is to replace it. But the number one thing is, give me a REST API, let me plug into that. I don't want to know about what's going on underneath the covers, but let me integrate my stack with that. And then the other realm is where we see the convergence of compute and storage together. So what we would call hyperconverged. And that market is, I think, still absolutely growing today. It's more application focused or traditional VDI or virtualized environments. Getting that to scale, I think, is the next. And the customers there are a little bit different, right? That may be not your traditional storage person, but the server or business unit.
So, Dave, to wrap up, I'm wondering if you can, as we look out a little bit, how are people thinking about Lenovo, and I guess maybe how will things be changing as we look going forward?
Yeah, well, from an overall, data center, the entire division, we'll be coming across as much more of an end-to-end solution provider, not just a one-trick pony with servers. We're gonna harness and leverage that server base, particularly as it relates to server-based SAN. We announced the Nutanix relationship that we had back in October. Lots of things coming from a storage-specific target later next month in May. So be on the lookout for that. But we internally we talked a little bit about how this is following a lot of the you know, kind of that classic innovator's dilemma kind of thing, where existing incumbents are offering more than what the market actually requires. So we're going to target, and you know, a lot of these ransom-like profits that the incumbents are garnering today, we're looking to bring a little bit, bring value back to the market. So stay tuned. It's we're going to get pretty noisy pretty quickly.
All right, Stuart, give you the last word here. Share some things people might not know about Lenovo, or a product that kind of stands out in the marketplace.
Yeah, I think that, to build on what Dave said, Lenovo storage, most people would say, Lenovo storage? I have no idea what that is. Where we're one of the top three server providers in the world, storage for us is a new business, right? So we're on a crawl, walk, run, and we're very focused on delivering value where customers can adopt that. The great thing is we have no legacy to protect, right? So we're going to be very disruptive, right? We're going to be, I think when you look back 2 years, you know, people say, man, they were the bad boy of the data center for storage because they came in and did stuff counter to what everyone else was doing, right? But for us, it's a market that's ripe for changing the dynamics, certainly the economic model, and that doesn't mean just cheap, 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 but delivering value to customers that they can really trust, right, to be the number one trusted data center provider for storage as well as servers.
All right, well, Dave Lincoln, Stuart McRae, thank you so much for joining us here. We'll be back with more coverage here from OpenStack 2016 in Austin. This is theCUBE.